Good morning, 108 students. Now we have already come to know that Bassanio has successfully married Portia. But before marrying Portia, or even after getting married to her, he did not want to hide any truth regarding himself. So Bassanio confessed to Portia that he had no fortune. Although he had come, he portrayed himself as a rich suitor, but now he is telling her the truth, and that his high birth and noble ancestry were all that he could boast of. So he had little property, ancestral property, that's all, and used to brag about it, boast a lot about it. Who loved him for his worthy qualities. Now, Portia was very taken up. She was very pleased that Bassanio very openly spoke the truth and had riches enough not to regard wealth in her husband. Answered with a graceful modesty that she would wish herself 1,000 times more fair and 10,000 times more rich. Now, when he admitted the fact that he was not a rich man, so she did not mind, because she herself has got sufficient richness, and that she did not have to depend on her husband's richness. Okay, so she, just to make him feel a little comfortable, she undermined herself. She says, to be worthy of Bassanio, to be Bassanio's wife, she says, I wish I was 1,000 times fairer, 10,000 times more richer than what she was. Okay. To be more worthy of him. And then the accomplished Portia prettily depraised herself and said she was an unlessoned girl, unschooled, unpractical, yet not so old but that she could learn, and that she would commit her gentle spirit to be directed and governed by him in all things. And she said, myself and what is mine to you and yours is now converted. But yesterday, Bassanio, I was lady of this fair mansion, queen of myself, and mistress over these servants. And now the house, the servants, and myself are yours. My lord, I give them with this ring, presenting a ring to Bassanio. Now, Bassanio was so overpure with gratitude and wonder at the gracious manner in which the rich and noble Portia accepted of a man of his humble fortune, that he could not express his joy and reverence to the dear lady who so honored him by anything but broken words of love and thankfulness. And taking the ring, he vowed never to part with it. Okay. So now she understood his sincerity. She forgave him. Then she accepted him as a husband, keeping this in mind, that as if she is not worthy to be his wife. So she wished that she would be 1,000 times prettier, 10,000 times more richer. Then she says, I am unlessoned, I am unschooled, I am unpractical, but never old. I will still learn and try to come up to be worthy to be your wife. And then she handed over all her things. She has already accepted Bassanio as her lord and governor, means now she will be totally under him. Then she handed over her building, herself, her servants, and everything that belongs to her now all belongs to Bassanio. And to confirm that she had given him a ring. Now this ring is very important. Okay, so he said, I will never part with it, neither I will lose it or give it away. So that promises he makes. So now in this episode, we come to know that Bassanio was extremely very happy. And along with them, Gratiano and Nerissa. Now remember, from the very on start, Nerissa always felt that the most suitable husband for Portia is Bassanio. And Gratiano also accompanied Bassanio to Belmont so that he would be successful in his mission, means be successful in marrying Portia. Now in the process, Gratiano and Nerissa, having the same opinion, having the same feeling, they also became very close to each other. They also fell in love with each other. Okay. So now, Gratiano and Nerissa, Portia's waiting maid, were in attendance upon their lord and lady. When Portia so gracefully promised to become the obedient wife of Bassanio, and Gratiano wishing Bassanio and the generous lady joy, desired permission to be married at the same time. So when Gratiano congratulated Bassanio and Portia, gave them the blessing, all the joy and happiness of the world, and then he made a request that he should also get married along with them. So Bassanio says, with all my heart, I agree. Very good, said Bassanio, if you can get a wife. Now in order to marry, you need a wife. Now remember, Gratiano had come to Belmont with Bassanio. At that time, he was not married, he was a bachelor. So that is why on those grounds Bassanio said, if you want to get married along with me, then you must have a wife. Gratiano then said that he loved the lady Portia's fair, waiting gentlewoman. Then Gratiano admitted the fact that he was in love with Nerissa. Nerissa, and that she had promised to be his wife if her lady married Bassanio. So Nerissa made a deal with Gratiano that if Bassanio marries Portia, or if Portia marries Bassanio, only then she will marry Gratiano. Portia asked Nerissa if this was true. Nerissa replied, Madam, it is so. If you approve of it, Portia willingly consenting, Bassanio pleasantly said, then our wedding feast shall be much honored by your marriage, Gratiano. I mean, Bassanio also agreed that they should get married together. The happiness of these lovers was sadly crossed at this moment by the entrance of a messenger who brought a letter from Antonio containing fearful tidings. When Bassanio read Antonio's letter, Portia feared it was to tell him of the death of some dear friend. Now what happens when a letter had come to Bassanio, sent by Antonio? Now remember, at that particular time, the mood was very good. They were all rejoicing, enjoying themselves. All of them were very happy. But after reading the content of this letter, suddenly Portia noticed a sudden change of expression on Bassanio's face, from a happy one to a sad one. So at once she understood that the content of the letter has got something that could not be worse than the news of some dear friend dead. So she had understood that the content in the letter was not very good. He looked so pale and inquiring what was the news which had so distressed him. She said, "O sweet Portia, here are a few of the unpleasantest words that ever blotted paper, gentle lady. When I first imparted my love to you, I freely told you all the wealth I had ran in my veins. But I should have told you that I had less than nothing, being in debt." Bassanio then told Portia what has been here related of his borrowing the money of Antonio and of Antonio procuring it of Shylock the Jew. And if the bond by which Antonio had engaged to forfeit a pound of flesh, if it was not paid by a certain day. And then Bassanio read Antonio's letter, the words of which were, "Sweet Bassanio, my ships are all lost, my bond to the Jew is forfeited, and since in paying it is impossible I should live, I could wish to see you at my death. Notwithstanding, use your pleasure, if your love for me do not persuade you to come, let not my letter." Now this is the situation at that particular time. Okay, now I'll explain the full thing. When the letter had come, suddenly there was a change in Bassanio's expression, and that was caught by Portia. She knew that the letter did not contain good news. And then Bassanio had to speak more. He had not actually told her everything about himself and how did he come to Belmont. So now he tells her that actually I have nothing. I didn't have any money to come to Belmont. I had borrowed this money from a friend, and my friend had to take the risk of his life in arranging the money for me, and he has to pay that money at a particular day. And unfortunately, what happened that he is not in a position to pay the money, and then if he is unable to pay the money, then a pound of flesh will be cut off from his body. And then he reads the letter. Now in the letter it was clearly stated that all Antonio's ships have been wrecked, have been lost, or have been destroyed. So his business went down, and he was not able to pay the money to the Jew, for which now the Jew is demanding, Shylock is demanding for that pound of flesh. So Antonio fears, while cutting down the flesh, the pound of flesh, he may lose his life. So he wanted that Bassanio should be present before he could die. So according to that, he sends his letter, and he also states that if this letter arrives at a nice time where you have a leisure time to read it, then it's okay. But if the letter comes at the wrong time, which is intervening or disturbing your marriage life, okay, and you are not able to come, then you have to behave that you have not received any kind of letter from me. Now when Portia heard this, she was, taken, it touched her heart. She says, "Come on, dispatch all the work and you go to Venice and give as much as money, but your friend's life should be spared. I don't want even a strand of hair of his to get hurt." Because now she has understood the depth of their friendship. So she gives all the money. They get married, and legally Bassanio can use, legally and freely he could use her money. So she equips him with a lot of money and gold and sends him to Venice. So I shall end it till here. Okay. Then again I shall continue of the next paragraph.